And a good Friday to everybody. The 13th, yes, Friday the 13th, but don't let that scare you folks, okay? I'm Jewel. This is the Weather Channel of J7409. And boy, oh boy, I told you guys to look out for the severe weather with tornadoes, hail, high wind, all that stuff yesterday. Sure enough, it, tell you what, Central Alabama, they've had, oh my goodness, 35 tornado reports. The place is a mess, and it may be even more than that now. And as of I know right now, it could be more, but at least 7 people have died in these tornadoes yesterday, and these is here. Now, we did have a few reports up in the western side of South Carolina, not as bad. We had a few down in Mississippi, and we had a few over in the very northern portion of Georgia. But Alabama, this area right in here, they really had it bad. So please keep your thoughts and your prayers with these people as they're trying to clean up. Now, right now, severe weather. What it's looking like, well, over here in northern California, and of course from central to southern Florida. We do have this chance of some isolated thunderstorms today, but they will happen during the afternoon and evening. But right now, it's looking like no chance of tornadoes, downdraft winds, or hail. So that's good so far as severe weather goes concerning tornadoes for today. Before I go any further, don't forget to subscribe. Click the J7409 Weather Ensemble in the bottom right-hand corner. Click the bell and make sure you check off all to make sure you get all my latest weather videos. We've got it all going on, folks. I'm telling you what. We've got another system coming into California. Watches and warnings. Everything's up for the lower 48 as well as areas of Puerto Rico and the island areas. Please go over to the community page and check it all out. See if you are in any of this. And make sure you stay tuned to your local weather forecast and your local authorities. This weather is a mess. And folks, everybody over here, we've been chilling out saying, hey, it's warmed up, man. Well, look out. The cold weather is coming again. This weekend is going to be severely cold from around Virginia Beach and eastern Virginia and moving right on down the coastlines here. These are daytime highs for today, as you can see in all the areas. Let's check out the nighttime lows. We are going to be in the 20s again. Ouch, ouch. Look, we got 20s. North Carolina, South Carolina, freezing in northern and the panhandle of Florida, Alabama, you're going to be 30. Look at all this cold air coming down. Indiana, 28, 19 around State College. The cold is coming back, folks, and it's going to last. Today, it is going to be probably like it showed, maybe in the upper 40s to mid 50s along this East Coast area here. But by after lunchtime, the temperature is going to start to fall, and it is going to get very, very cold. And it will be cold for all day, Saturday night, Sunday, and Sunday night, before we start to see any kind of trend to get warmer again. I'm going to use a NAM map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits, this morning for the next 3 days. I know you guys like this as I turn it on. You know, I told everybody yesterday that all of the unsettled weather in the West Coast with the active atmospheric river, you were going to have another one. And unfortunately, you are. It is continued for another storm this weekend with another couple of rounds of some very heavy precipitation in the forecast. Now, in the lower elevation valley and coastal rain and high elevation mountain snow, it's already started, folks. Started early today in the Pacific Northwest, and it's going to spread into California through all day today as another Pacific storm system approaches the coast. Now, the system will stall and weaken a little as the ridging is going to build inland over the west. Now, that's keeping overall rain and snow totals relatively a little bit lighter in this area compared to the other systems. One exception, though, will be for coastal Northern California, Southern Oregon, where a stream of higher Pacific moisture will roughly parallel the coast, and it's going to remain in place over the region. Now, that's going to lead to a much longer duration of showers and heavier rainfall rates for you guys. Now, rainfall is in place for both coastal Northern California, where rainfall will continue today, as well as upslope regions in the Sierra. Flood watches, they're out. Go check them out. They're in effect for the Sacramento and San Jose Valleys. Rainfall totals 1 to 2 inches along the coast and interior valleys upward to 3 to 5 inches of rain. Now, that's going to make this chance of flooding a whole lot better. A few instances of flooding, even maybe some more mudslides could happen, and very heavy snow is forecast for the Sierra with another 2 to 3 or plus possibly by early Sunday. One of my subscribers put a comment up yesterday that one of her family members lives out in these areas where the snow is falling down in the Tahoe area. The snow was almost to the rooftop of their cabin. Can you imagine? Now, this moisture, as you see, it's going to begin to spread further inland over the west, and that's because ridging over the region will begin to break down Saturday. Now, precipitation over most lower elevation valley locations, that's going to start as snow Saturday before it transitions into a wintry mix of sleet and snow for the Great Basin and the Northern and Central Rockies. Now, higher elevation mountain locations, particularly from central Idaho, south into Nevada, and the Four Corners region, you can expect snow totals through Sunday morning of 4 to 8 inches, maybe even more. And the temperatures will remain rather mild with this ridging in place ahead of the storm system Saturday. So that's going to help you out just a little bit. Now, rain and snow will linger through today for portions of the Midwest, the Appalachians, and East Coast. It's going to get cold over here, folks. East Coast cold front. It's going to pass through this morning. I'm thinking after lunchtime today. And any additional rainfall total should be light outside of coastal Maine, where you guys have a flood watch in effect through this afternoon. Now, some moderate snow totals, 2 to 4 inches, maybe a little more, are forecast in the lake effect locations in the lower Great Lakes, the Adirondacks, and New York, and portions of the central and southern Appalachians. As a matter of fact, right over where North Carolina meets Tennessee on the line right here, all of these counties, for Tennessee and North Carolina, if you live on the line there, you have winter storm warnings, folks. Be aware of it, okay? Be aware of it. Now, some higher snow totals of 8 to 12 inches are possible for northern Maine, the Great Smoky Mountains, as I've just pointed it out. Now, some sleet and light accumulations of freezing rain, that's going to be possible, too, for northern New England as the warmer air pushes northward ahead of the cold front by today. Now, it will change back over to snow, so please be aware of this. And like in central West Virginia, including Charleston, you guys are going to get snow too. It may be rain, it may be freezing rain, and it'll change over and it's going to be snow. So some could happen Monday. You might get a little snow in Boston, Massachusetts. Now, I've told you about how it's going to get cold, especially over in these areas here, all the way down to Florida, even over in these areas here. The cold is going to last through this coming weekend, possibly Monday. But Monday, hopefully at some time, the temperature should moderate just a little bit. But go ahead and prepare. It's going to be in the 20s. That's mighty, mighty cold, okay? And that's not counting wind chill. So please be aware and be prepared. That's what it's looking like right now, folks. So don't put up the heavy coats yet. Winter is going to be here. The weather is just wacko, as we all know. It's a roller coaster ride. That's what we're going to live through for the next few years, folks. I'm just telling you, up and down and up and down. You have to be prepared for anything at any time. That's the best advice that I can give you. Hey, thanks for everything you do for me. Please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware of what's coming their way. And also, Safari Snow. I know a lot of people are saying, what about Eastern North Carolina? Eastern North Carolina, we're going to have some cold rain. Okay? Now, when you move just a little further west inland, past Greenville, say maybe Kinston, you could possibly, now I'm not saying you're going to, you could possibly have some rain, a little freezing rain, a little snow, but none of it will amount to anything, okay? I'll put it like that. Mostly it's going to be rain. So once again, check out everything over on the community page. Click show more down below this video. There is a link that'll take you right over there to it. And may each of you stay warm. Be prepared for whatever kind of weather's coming your way, folks. Anytime now. We never know. We got to watch this on a day-to-day basis. Have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day, my friends. I love each and every one of you, and I thank you so much for watching, subscribing, giving me a thumbs up, and sharing this information. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thank you for watching.